Bonjour tout le monde. Good morning again. Monday again, another week of learning. These weeks pass very quickly, don't they? It's very interesting because we have to make the most of every second that we have. There's no point thinking about the future and wishing for different things to happen, wishing your time away, wishing for the weekend, wishing for Sunday. We've got to make the most of every single second. So here we are again, back at school for Monday, another fantastic week of learning, and another week to think about our theme. And again, we're now starting to get used to this new theme, and people around school are telling me what the new theme is. We seem to have put the old theme behind us now, but it's important that we continue to think about that. The keys to success, hard work, determination, still think about that, but it's lovely to hear children talking about our new theme. Be the change you wish to see in the world. Your dreams can come true if you have the courage to pursue them. And I did say I would give a special mention to Year 4 this week for being the ones that are constantly talking to me about this theme. And another shout out this morning to a little boy who last term, every time he saw me, talked about the keys to success. And he caught me on the stairs this week and he said, "Mrs. Williams, I know our new theme." And that's Toby James. So well done, Toby James, for constantly reminding me of what our theme is. You should be very proud. So as always though, our first thing we do in our new assembly, let's just move the slides on, if I can find where the button is. There we go. We start our assemblies with our composer in the spotlight. So can you still, these should be really, really ingrained in your memory now. Can you still, the name of the composer we studied last half term, Mozart. When was he born? 1756. When did he die? 1791. What was the period of music called? Classical. Who taught him to read and play music? His dad. He could play the harpsichord by the age of 3. And can you name one piece of music that he wrote? Horn concerto, piano concerto, eine kleine Nachtmusik, exultate, jubilate. Can you name them all? Well done. Okay. And let's just move on now to our next slide and look at our composer in the spotlight for this half term, Chopin. And remember, he was a pianist, born in 1810, died in 1849, and his period of music is called the Romantic period. And we're going to listen to some of his music now, and then we'll be back in 2 or 3 minutes to think about our theme, Be the Change You Wish to See in the World. So here is this week's music, Waltz number 9 in A flat, known as the Farewell Waltz. Thank you. Okay, so that was Chopin's Farewell Waltz. But back to our theme now and back to our assembly for this week. Be the change you wish to see in the world. So one of the changes I would like to see in the world is that I think far too often we are very quick to judge other people or to make assumptions about other people or look at what somebody is doing and think we know why they're doing it or the reason for that action. And quite often, that assumption is wrong. The reason we attribute to why somebody else is doing something is not the reason that they're doing that at all. We put our own impression and our own thoughts onto somebody else, and we assume when we see somebody doing something, or when we see someone acting in a particular way, or when we see a particular behaviour, we assume they're doing it for a reason. But that reason is our assumption. That reason is something that we think, and it might be completely wrong. They might not be doing that for that reason at all. So the change that I would like to see in the world is that we listen to people more. We ask people more, why did you do that? What's the reason behind that action? Why did you choose to do what you did? Instead of making the assumption, instead of believing that we are right, instead of using our thoughts to project onto other people, actually listening to others. Because we don't know what's going on in someone else's head. We don't know what someone else is thinking. I've said many, many times, I would love it if I could slit open your head and look inside your brain and understand what you are thinking. But I can't. I can't do that. So you have to tell me what you are thinking. You have to tell me your thoughts. I don't know how well you're learning. I don't know how well you're listening to me right now. I can simply look at you and assume. But you have to be the one that tells me how you're feeling, how you're thinking, how you're learning. So there'll be some questions to answer. That's how you can tell me how you're thinking. And I'm going to read a story to you that demonstrates how sometimes we get it really wrong. We get our assumptions about what other people are doing or thinking. We get it really wrong. And the change that I want to see in the world is that we do more listening to other people. And if I want that to happen, then I'm going to be the first person to do it. I'm going to make a real effort this week to listen to you, listen to the teachers, listen to the parents. Tell me what you're thinking. Don't assume to know what I'm thinking, and I won't assume to know what you're thinking. Let's talk and let's listen to this story and think about what went wrong. There was once a poor tailor. Now, a tailor is somebody who sews, makes clothes. That the person who makes clothes is called a tailor. So there was once a poor tailor who made very good suits, jackets, trousers and coats. He was so good at his job, he made such good clothes that the king heard about them and asked the tailor to make him a coat. The tailor worked and worked in his tiny dark workroom. He cut beautiful cloth. He sewed fine stitches with silk thread. He stitched on gold and silver buttons and a collar of velvet. And at last, the coat was finished and he took it to the palace. The king tried the coat on and twizzled and turned in front of the mirror to see what he looked like in it. And at last he stood still and said, "It's a very fine coat. In fact, it's the finest I've seen. You're an excellent tailor. You can be the royal tailor from now on." "Oh, thank you," said the tailor. And from that very day, the tailor went to the king's palace every week to show the king materials and to sew some new clothes for the king. Well, The king soon learned that the tailor was very good at something else besides sewing. He was very good at listening and giving advice. Sometimes the king would tell the tailor about a problem or another, and the tailor would listen carefully. And then he would suggest to the king that he try this or try that or try something else to solve the problem. The tailor was a very kind, fair and thoughtful man, and he always gave the king good advice. Well, one day, as he was trying on a new suit, the king said, I think you are too clever to be my tailor. I would like you to come and live at this palace and be my prime minister, my chief advisor. What do you think? The tailor stood still and thought. Yes, he said, I would really like to do that. Good, said the king, you can start tomorrow. So the very next day, the tailor packed up all of his belongings and moved into his new home in the king's palace, ready to start his new job. The tailor became a very good prime minister and chief advisor and helped lots of important people in the palace, as well as the king. But the people in the palace sometimes noticed something quite strange about him. Wherever he went, the prime minister and chief advisor always carried with him a small wooden box. The people said, what does he keep in that box? He takes it everywhere with him. And this is where the assumptions start to come in. So this is where I need you to really listen carefully. The people have seen the tailor carrying a box. They don't know what's in that box. They are making an assumption. They're making a judgment. That judgment might not be right. Listen very carefully. It must be something really valuable. He dared put it down. Or leave it anywhere, they said. It must be treasure, they said. Perhaps it's the treasure that belongs to the king, they said. Perhaps it is treasure that he has stolen from the king, they said. That's it, the people shouted. He is stealing jewels from the king's treasure house, and he's hiding them in that wooden box. He never puts it down, he never leaves it anywhere, because he doesn't want anybody to look inside the box and know that he is stealing the king's jewels. Are they right? All of these people have convinced themselves that they are right about what is in that little box. They don't know what's in that box. They haven't looked in that box. It's like me. I don't know what's in your head. I can't look inside your head. We can only assume. And on this occasion, I wonder if those assumptions are right. I wonder if what they are thinking about this man is correct. The people decided to take the prime minister and chief advisor to the king and make him open the wooden box and show the king the stolen jewels. They caught hold of him, marched him to the king. Then they explained to the king about the stolen jewels that were in the box. That's not very nice to make that man go through that experience, is it? March him to the king, make him open the box and tell the king what's in the box. Well, said the king, is there treasure in that wooden box of yours? Oh yes, answered the prime minister and chief advisor, the tailor. I'm going to show you. He opened the box. And there inside were pins and needles, scissors, thread, tailor's chalk, all the tools that a tailor uses, but not the king's jewels. This is my treasure, he said. I keep my tailor's tools in this box to remind me of my humble beginnings. Now that I have an important job, I might get big-headed. So I keep these things with me to stop that and to remind myself I'm just an ordinary tailor. I've stolen nothing. I'm sorry, said the king. We are sorry, too, said the people. That's all right, said the Prime Minister. Doesn't matter. And he forgave them all for thinking badly of him. It's really important. The change I want to see in the world is that we don't judge people. We ask them. We listen to them. And we don't assume. We don't assume people are clever. We don't assume people are not clever. We simply ask you to come to school and to work hard and to learn. We don't assume anything about you at all. That's the change that I want to see in the world, where we are all judged on what we do, not what we actually think about you. And I want to spend my time this week listening more. Not assuming, but listening. Hands together and eyes closed. Thank you, God, for all of our treasures. Help us to realise that things don't have to be worth a lot of money to be treasures to us, to be worth a lot to us, and to mean a lot to us. Help us to care for our treasures so that they will give us happiness for a long time. Amen. Children, you are all my treasures. You are the important things in this school. And I'm here for you. I'm here to listen. And I'm here to learn from you. And you're here to learn from me. So let's have a fantastic week. And let's remember to learn, sparkle, and shine. Well done. And the song that you've been learning about the big, 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 big crazy world, we've got year four videoed singing it this week. So we're going to play, watch year four, and I want you all to join in about you can be the change in this big, crazy world. You can make a difference in this big, crazy world. There's lots of things that are unfair in this big, crazy world, but you can make the difference. So sing along. Raise the roof and remember, I will see you around school. Tell me, be the change, and I want to see you being the change. Have a great week.
Change the future and save us. stars and cities. Food is always fresh. Special brands and labels, nothing but the best. People that have plenty, throwing food away. When in other places they can afford to play. It's a big, 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 big crazy world. It's a big, 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 big crazy world. Make it.